don't know how much it means as an artist to give you a part of ourselves like we give you a part of ourselves. Let me ask you a question. How many people, by a round of applause, still believe in love? I still believe in love too, but how many people believe that man, this is for you? Sometimes we just gotta grow the hell up sometimes. Can I get a witness, ladies? This is my grow up story right here. This is called Somewhere Between High and By. Somewhere Between High and By. We met, we spoke, we touched, we kissed, we loved, we walked away. Against all odds, we came together. From two different worlds, we never thought that love would bite so hard until we caught that. And when I caught it, I lied to myself, so I fought it. Assessed the emotional stress and found that it just didn't match. So I got audited. Somewhere between high and by, we gave in to the lust of the flesh and skin. And it led us to being more than just friends. See, baby, you became the reason why my seasons changed. The easing of my aches and pains. The stimulant to my brain, the beautiful sound to my voice. Every time that I spoke your name. We both follow the rules and regulations of this love. I accepted a gift in you, and all I wanted in return was for you to accept all of me. Besides, you allowed me to see another side of me that was hidden. Although forbidden, you inspired me to write some things that I wrote that had never before been written. And you relieved my stress. You were my calm after the storm, my peace in the midst of confusion. See, baby, you came and made sense out of all this mess. Somewhere between high and by, you made me feel like black ice was never alone. Always made me feel wanted and offset all the complaining at home. And those tears you dropped for me, I tried my best to catch them. I never wanted to make you feel neglected, respected your feelings and your emotions. I tried my best to protect them. But see, baby, we were past the point of no return. And that's when I learned how quick on this highway of love, how you can take a wrong turn. And now I'm concerned about your hurt. My conscience is telling me that I'm a part of the pain as a result of doing dirt. I'm thinking maybe I should just leave your ass alone. And maybe I should just work on building what I already have at home. Somewhere between high and by, things ended up real serious when they all started out as fun. But see, baby, pulling away from you will prove to be much easier said than done. Because now you're agitated, and with every little disagreement, you act real aggravated. Cause see, somewhere between high and by, we both created a love out of lies, and now I realize that life and love is only what you make it. In the beginning, I just wish we could have put this shit on disc and saved it. But now everything is twisted and turned upside down. And that beautiful smile you used to have is turned into a frown. And I'm thinking, where did we go wrong? Did we try to suppress a love that was too strong? Did we cross that line beyond friends? Did we extend what we had too long? Man, if only I could write a silly love poem, I would write it all about you. Somewhere between high and by, we both walked away. And although we both wanted to stay, the price would have been too high for both of us to pay. Because with each brick we built, it would have been layered with lies, covered by our friends, bearing false witnesses, false statements, and false alibis. Besides, the right and wrong choices are made based on the way you choose them. But see, baby, you better be damn sure that the same way you get somebody is the same way you lose them. Maybe next lifetime. And maybe our reasons, they just ran out of rhyme. Somewhere between high and by, we met, we spoke, we touched, we kissed, we loved, we walked away. That's that piece. Everybody got an alter ego, right? My alter ego is called Tony Swagger. Y'all check this out.
I guess you heard about Tony Swag.
I don't know that you heard my name.
And the way your boy gets down.
Girl, I do my thing.
Made me think I need a change of weather.
Something I do.
And you just be just what I need. So
to make me settle down.
See, baby, there comes a time in every man's life when life causes him to think twice. Check his conduct, sacrifice. Give up that old life for a new life. And you just might be the motivation that I needed. In the beginning, I just couldn't see it. But I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. And during the storm, seems like everybody left me cold and alone. But you, and maybe true enough, I've had my fun, but now I'm shifting my challenge to not how many but one. And I'm trying to be a good example for my son on how to identify and treat a real woman. And baby, despite what it appears to you, yeah, Tony Swagger get lonely too. We gonna do a little something like this. Put those hands together. I don't give a damn about all the rumors
that they're saying.
But Tony Swag, I get lonely too. All of my verbal stimulations. But shorty
babe,
I think that
I need you.
I never realized what I was missing out on in life. At the height of my career and gift, and absolutely no one to share it with. Late nights, different hotels, and night, taking them hoes to the hotel. Cause well, them hoes will tell. Hell, I was trying to cover my past hurt with dirt. Bury my emotions in a shallow grave. A victim of the slave trade. Trade my emotions for feelings, literally. And it appeared to be more appealing. Feeling me. Until one day I took that lone look in the mirror. And that's when things began to get clearer. I saw myself standing there all alone. And I didn't want to write another silly love poem. And so I wrote this song and it went like this. Come on, y'all. I don't give a damn about all the rumors.
I don't care about it.
But Tony Swag, I get lonely too. All of my verbal stimulations. Can y'all help me out on this part right here? Shorty babe, I think what? I think that check this out, y'all. I remember when I used to please them, then tease them, you know. Make them think I wanted a relationship, love them and leave them. I was cold as ice long ago. I used to keep women around me just for show. But that was before I laid eyes on you. And before I laid ice on you. So amazing that it was electric. Way more than I ever expected. And maybe all I know is just want some more to love without taking off my clothes. Just want some more to love somebody who knows that I got more money than you can ever see. My honey, honey, won't pick me up.
All my
need. I need y'all to help me take it home, Chicago. Put those hands together. I don't give a damn. I don't give a damn about all the rumors. But Tony Swag, I get lonely too. Yeah, all of my verbal stimulations. But surely, babe, I think what? I think that
I need you, baby.
Thank y'all so much. I want to close out. I want to close out with my testimony and then I'm going to get to the old school for you. I want to get my girl Alicia Ma up on stage. I've been wanting to perform with her for such a long time now, and it seems like I might get the opportunity tonight. But I want to get my sister Alicia Ma up on stage. And, oh, she in the front? Okay, cool. The name of this piece right here is called Ego. It's a testimony piece. And this piece was written when I lost my 15-year-old son to cancer. Ego is an acronym that stands for easy, God, out. Hey, God.
Where you at? I've been looking for you. Seems like you've been avoiding me or something. And I've been searching for you for years with no answer, just anticipation. And I've been going through this transformation, but every time I call on you, God, it's like I get put on hold. And they say that you hear all and that you see all, but seems like you ain't never available, God, when I call. See, y'all, I remember it was January 91. I had just left Simeon's Martin Luther King ceremony speaking. I wasn't feeling too well that day. Little did I know that all the while, my appendix had been leaking. And where were you, God? Just what I thought, nowhere to be found. And if it wasn't for my son's mother convincing me to go to St. Bernard's that night, Black Ice wouldn't be here with you right now. And where were you at, God, that morning when I went to work and when I got to 123rd and Kesey, right by the cemetery, this lady ran the light. The last thing I saw, y'all, was headlights. A three-car collision that almost took my life, but where were you, God? And where were you at, God, when my son died? I sat there at the University of Chicago and I watched him come back twice. You could have intervened, you could have saved his life, but where were you, God?
Where were you? Oh, when I needed you, where were you?
Where were you, God?
Where were you?
I need to know, where were you?
When I was down in love.
When I was down, where were you, God?
When I had nowhere to go.
I ain't have nowhere to go, where were you? He said, okay, my son, I've heard enough. Now I know that times for you have been rough, but son, where's your faith? Seems like you only seek my face when you need me, for I am a full-time God, my son. Do you really believe in me? Yeah. Well, if so, then you would know that I am the creator of the universe. All that you see from the highest heights of heaven to what you have discovered beneath the earth. I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I am the God of Moses, Lot, and David. I am the one who made Solomon wise. I put Noah in the ark before those waters could rise. I gave Samson the strength to destroy the Philistines with no eyes.
Where is your faith? Where is your faith in me? Because you know, when you need me, I'll be there, yeah.
I am that smooth stone that David slung to smoke Goliath in the head. The cracks that crumble the walls of Jericho, the same one that rose Lazarus from the dead. I am the blood of the lamb on the doorpost that kept the children of Israel safe from harm. Even the staff in Moses' right arm, and I gave the power to split the Red Sea in half. Shall I go on?
I'm powerful, and you know I'm got your back, yeah. So don't lose faith in me.
I said, please forgive me, Father.
Please forgive me, Father.
He said, no, son, I already have.
Yes, I have.
But see, like Jonah, you've been running from your mission. I've been trying to reach you and speak to you for years, but your ego just wouldn't let you listen. When your appendix was spreading poison through your body, I was the voice that spake to your son's mother warning you, and do you remember what you promised me, my son?
Humble yourself.
Yes, Lord, I do. I promise you that if you allow me to make it through, then I would turn my life over to you. But what did you do? You continued to play. So I spoke to you again in the form of a three-car collision, but I allowed you to walk away that day. And have you ever asked yourself the question why the accident was by a gravesite? I was showing you that the road that you were traveling on ended at the cemetery if you didn't change your life.
I will teach you lessons that you need to learn. I will teach you when you need to know.
He said, and I know your son's gone, but his body was sick, so I relieved him of his pain and I called him home. And yet and still I stayed by your side all those moments that you felt alone, yet you still rejected my truth. If you only could have put your ego to the side and listened to all those whom I sent to you. Lord, you mean to tell me why all the while I was waiting to hear from you? You were sending me messages through all those whom I rejected. Yes, my son, this is true. And instead of focusing on the guides, submit to the truth that you find inside. For Satan is the one who subtracts and divides, but I am the one who adds and multiplies. I'm telling y'all, he opened my eyes. And so to those of you who can't accept the truth, because your ego won't allow you to accept who the truth is coming through, take this as a lesson. Because see, God just ain't using these pastors today, because asking some of these pastors questions is just like asking blind men for directions. But it's the truth that counts. And see y'all, in this case, my ego just wasn't my ego. But my ego was easing.
It was easing.
God.
Oh,
out. Thank you.